few years back, Akai released MPC Beats, an amazing gift to the production community. It is a slightly cut down version of the MPC software, and this is the sound engine that is legendary for kicking out the best drums and key group instruments, as well as that swing. Let me show you around the basics of MPC Beats and build a short house production using our free MPC expansion, Ignition Volume 1. The very first thing to do is head up here in the main menu and check for updates. Often the version that you download via email will not be the latest. This is the way to do it. Click download update on anything that shows up, grab the file and open and install it. That will make sure that you're running the very latest operating system with all the latest effects and bug fixes. So now let's add the Ignition expansion. And this is the MPC expansion file. So I'm just going to pick that up and drop that straight onto the MPC Beats. You'll get this little splash screen expansion pack import. I'm just going to hit import there. To access the expansions, all you've got to do is come down here onto the right. And if I scroll down through my expansion list, there we go. F9 Ignition Volume 1. Click on it and it'll show you the internal structure. The main thing you want to head to are the programs. You've got three types here. Instrument, these are the multi-sampled key group instruments. Drum kits and the sound menus here, which are drum kits that have just one type of instrument spread across the actual pad. So if we were to load the hats, we'd get a whole series of drum pads with just hat sounds on, and they're ever so useful to add elements to your actual productions. Now, if you want to hear previews of anything that you're loading, turn this little autoplay icon on here, and I'm going to head to the sequences folder here. This contains the MIDI for the different drum kits. Let's look in the house folder. Going to click on the Rockfield kit, and we should have an audio preview. So by double clicking the sequence, not only did I actually load the drum kit into memory, but I've actually also added the sequence data. I'm just going to turn the limiter off and drop the volume level of the whole kit a moment. And if I zoom right out, you'll see we've got a full 8-bar sequence here. I'm also going to visit the program section, flip down to the instruments, and I want a classic house organ. Here we've got one, and it comes from the F9 Origins MPC expansion. Double-click that to load. So now let me talk you around the basics of the MPC system. Up here in this top left is where you're going to spend a lot of your time. You've got some general modes here for different things, from editing the kits. You can see all the parameters appearing down the bottom. Sample edit and two types of mixer, as well as a sample record function and a looper. You will probably spend most of your time on the program edit mode or the sample editor. The most important unit of currency in the MPC system is a sequence. And the sequence is like an advanced pattern. You can see I've got one here. I can go to a blank one and it'll automatically create it. And you can see there's room for the third one. Let's just go back to our main sequence. You can see here that the sequence is 8 bars long. It is set to loop. And also it contains the tempo information. Every single sequence can have its own tempo. Underneath that section is this part here, which is the track area. And here is our house drum kit. It's important to understand that there are different types of track within the MPC system, and whatever MIDI data is shown is sent to that type of device, and you can even flip between them. The first type of track is a drum kit. The next type of track is called a key group track, and this is where you get the multi-sampled and fully playable instruments. The next one is a plugin, and there are three plugins built into MPC Beats. Tube Synth loads automatically. There's another simpler synth called Bassline, and an electric piano module called Electric. But if you come up to Preferences and head to the Plugins tab, you can actually set your system locations for VST and audio units and scan all of your plugins and have access to them here as well. One thing to bear in mind is that we're in the MPC Beats standalone application, but if you run this as a plugin, all of the scanned plugins that you've put in from your own system will also be available. So this is a fantastic way to run VST-only plugins inside of something like Logic that only uses AUs. The next track type is MIDI, and this is for sending the sequence data out to external MIDI devices. The next track type is clip, and this is like a loop launcher or a clip launcher. And the last one, CV, this is only really connected to the MPC hardware, a lot of which has CV outputs on the back, and we don't need to worry about that here. Now, whilst we're here, one of the most basic gotchas with an NPC, if you're not familiar with it, is that you're sending the MIDI information to the wrong place. So whatever is on this track will be sent to whatever device that you select up here on the track selector. Now, that means you can accidentally change from a drum kit into a key group and get a complete mess. Let me show you what I mean. So here's the drum MIDI, and I'm going to change the track type to a key group, and it's going to play now our organ. So if you ever get anything like that, you know what's happened. You're basically sending the wrong type of MIDI information into the wrong type of track. So let's flip that back to the drum kit. So now let's get an organ part recorded over the top of our drum kit. So I'm going to flip to track two, change it to key group, and there the organs come straight up. Here's what it sounds like. Now let's set this up for record. I'm going to turn the timing correct on up here. You can see it's set to time correct automatically to 16ths. And here's that MPC swing. Now I'm going to set this up to, let's really give it some groove. Let's set it up to 60 and start recording. I would always suggest you get in the habit of hitting the overdub button. The reason being is if you hit just record, it will wipe out any previous MIDI information. And I've got two options here. If I hit just the green play button, it's going to start recording from this part here. But I want the counting in to start at the top of the bar, so I'm going to hit the play from start control. Now you have to excuse my playing, I'm fighting against some pretty serious latency with the screen capture. Now I'm just going to tighten things up, so let's zoom in a little bit. As you can see, you've got the standard sliders for zoom. Now what's really handy here, with time correction still held on, it will snap to the nearest values. If you want a little bit more fine control, turn that off and then it's completely continuous. You can go to whatever levels that you want. That sounds great. So I'm going to double click on here where it says track two and we'll type in organ. Now we're naming the actual tracks as well. Let's double click on the sequence name. We'll go F9 house demo. Of course, once you've started to do everything, don't forget to save. And you want to encapsulate everything by saying save project as. This will save absolutely everything, including all of the sample data. Now, one thing to note is that the MPC, because it's having to mimic what happens in hardware, has a completely bespoke browser window. It does take a little bit of getting used to, I must admit. We know those four bars work perfectly, so I'm going to select all Apple A or Control A on the keyboard and just pick them all up and drag them across. So let's just balance this organ sound against the drum kit. Now there are a few different modes for these faders here on the left, and let me quickly go through them. I've gone back to the track that has the drum kit on, and just quickly while I'm here, another gotcha. If you're ever trying to record notes in from a MIDI controller or pads and it's not working, make sure that this button here, this red button, the record arm, is turned on. The first time it happened to me, it took me about 10 minutes to find this. Now on this drum kit, if I select the different sounds on the track list here, and you'll see the pad selection changing on the bottom as I do so, you'll see that things are changing on the fader on the left. This is because we have the information section that you can toggle on and off with the little eye here. We have it on pad channel mode. So in other words, if I'm on a drum kit, I can then actually alter the volume level of that, just that one pad, using the fader here and apply effects just to that one drum sound. And talking about effects, we're in program edit mode. Look at all of the parameters that are available on every single drum hit. This is an incredible system for it being free. If I now go to the track that has the organ on, you'll see it's changed a little bit here, and there is this additional box where if I click on it, you'll see all of the different key groups. Now, these are the different key spans that actually make this patch up. So you can alter them on a per key group level. Now, on an instrument, you're probably not going to want to play too much with the individual key groups, but you will want to play with the overall sound, and that can be reached here on this fader and with this strip of effects. Now, if I change the mode of this info panel to program mode, you'll see that it kind of slips everything to the left. So here is our overall program for the organ, including the effects chain. And now what we have is the output of the entire MPC in this space. And we've got the same functionality when we're on a drum kit. So in other words, if I flip back to pad channel, there's the actual pad. You can select the pad number that you want from here. There's the overall program of the drum kit. Now I go to program and channel, and here again, you have access to the master fader of the MPC. And of course, you can add effects to that master channel as you would any other position. And understanding this architecture will really help when you come to the two different mixers. The pad mixer here allows you to individually mix and level and effect every single drum pad or every single key group within a program, where the second channel mixer has a much more top-down view, and these are the outputs of those individual drum kits or the key group programs. Now, one thing to bear in mind, the levels and the effects on these tracks here will affect every single sequence in your current project. So I've added a whole series of parts here, all sounds from the Ignition pack. Let me take you through them one by one. First of all, we've got the piano. And I'm actually going to add a touch more delay to this. Next up, I added this stab. Just going to open up the channel strip and increase the high pass filter. Added a nice little string pad in the background. But it's got quite a short attack, so I'm going to need to edit this patch. And this is a really important part of understanding how the editing system works. So we're going to go to Program Edit. I'm going to get us to the right track, which is the string track. And here is the patch information at the bottom here for Belfast Strings. Now, this is a key group program. And one of the problems is that you can edit just one key group. So you see down here where it says the word key group, and I've got the number 8. This means that we are only editing number 8 of 21 different key groups. What we want to do is come up to the top and select all. Here's the amp envelope. It's quite short at the moment. I'm going to increase that so it comes in a lot slower, and actually probably give it a bit more release as well. And I'm sure you can hear the power of this engine pumping out those classic house sounds. It is really tight. The audio engine of this entire system is fantastic for punchy sounds. On track 7, I've added this binary key part. And on the last track, please bear in mind this is an 8-track only system, are some vinyl effects. So now I've actually used up 8 tracks of the maximum here, so it's time to actually render this out. And I'm going to come up to the export menu that's in the main file menu, bearing in mind in the standalone version you can get to it at the top, or you could get to it from these menus here at any point. So let's do it from here, export. And you've got two excellent options here. If you're an Ableton Live user, believe it or not, you can render it out as an Ableton Live set with 8 tracks of bounce down audio. But we're going to do this as an audio mixdown. So here, and these are the options. So we start at bar 1, end at bar 8. That's an 8-bar sequence. That's fine. It's got an audio tail of 1 second. We'll give it a little bit more just in case there's any audio that we want to tail over. Now, normally it defaults to just render out the stereo, which is the entire mix. But what we want to do is explode the tracks. Now, this explode will basically render out a separate audio file for each of the eight tracks. 24-bit, 44.1, we're going to hit export. And we'll just say F9, demo, and go, go, go. It will now render out each of the eight tracks. Now, of course, if you are an Ableton user, you can always render out as Ableton Live Set. We want everything as audio. We want to include the volume and the pan settings, and we don't want to bypass any of the program effects. We'll do the same thing. We'll give it a tail of 2 seconds, 24-bit, 44.1. Now I'm going to render in a very similar fashion, but instead of just putting out audio files, it is actually going to create an Ableton Live Set. Now, there's only one problem. This process bounces out the outputs at the program level. So in other words, all of the drums are going to be submixed into one stereo file. Well, can we get around this? We certainly can. Come up to the edit menu, and in the sequence, we're going to copy the sequence. So we're going to take sequence number one, which is our main sequence, dump it in to number two. So here it is. We're on the second sequence now, which is a copy of the first. And now we're going to be a bit cheeky. We're going to come up to sequence and we're going to copy track. And what I'm going to do is copy the information from the house kit onto every other track. So now I'm only going to do two here and then I'll scoot forward once it's all complete. Okay, that's complete, and what I've basically got now is the same information on every single one of the eight tracks. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is to start deleting data. So I'm only going to have the kick on this track, so I'm going to delete absolutely everything else. Now for this second track, I'm just going to have the clap, so let me quickly get rid of absolutely everything else apart from the clap. Track three are going to be the snares. Track four will be my hats. And I'm sure you can see what I'm doing here. And now I've done all eight tracks. So now all I've got to do is go through the same explode tracks style of export. So here we are, a lovely set of stem outputs ready for you to work on. And remember that Ableton Live set we made? Well, here we go. Compatible with Ableton and Ableton Lite as well. Let's just turn them down a bit. All bounced out beautifully though. Everything I've just created has been done with completely free releases. MPC Beats is free for every single DAW user, and so is F9 Ignition. The sounds from Ignition are taken from three excellent MPC packs that we've recently released. F9 Origins covers classic house. F9 Electric Funk covers that amazing era in the 80s when the drum machines and the synthesizers collided with funk music. F9 Neptunes covers all sorts of modern contemporary keyboard sounds. All three are available now, as is the full version of the MPC Software V2, which we highly recommend. So an incredible system here from Akai, and we can't thank them enough for allowing this to be free for the production community. I hope you get some amazing use out of it. Thanks for watching this short intro to MPC Beats, and we'll see you next time.